Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss an algorithm to construct DFA directly from regular expression without constructing NFA. The process we have seen so far is converting a regular expression into NFA, then using subset construction, we are constructing the DFA from the NFA. Now we will see an algorithm which will construct a DFA directly from regular expression without constructing NFA. So for this, the first step is to make the final state of the regular expression or the NFA which represent the regular expression. The final state should be made an important state. Okay. So what is an important state? That any state in NFA is important state if it has non-E out transition, means there is no transition out of the state with E moves, with the level E. Okay, so given an acceptance state of any NFA, okay, generally the NFA which represents the regular expression I'm looking for. So this NFA can be made important by concatenating a unique end marker to the regular expression. Okay, say for example, the regular expression, for example, we are considering is A or B star ABB. Then we use a hash where this hash is not present in the alphabet set or the sigma. Okay, which is constructing the language of this regular expression. So a special character hash is concatenated. So, remember that this concatenation is the last operation performed on this regular expression. So which makes the acceptance state of this regular expression or this NFA as an important state, the first step. In the second step, we are going to construct syntax tree for the regular expression given to us. Okay, with the end marker, with the given end marker. So given A or B star ABB as per the precedence of the operations in the regular expression, with the parenthesis is the highest precedence, then star is the second highest precedence, then we say concatenation and the lowest precedence is R. Okay. So we follow the same procedure as constructing any syntax, any expression tree, any arithmetic expression tree to construct this syntax tree. So for example here, so we got parenthesis as the highest precedence here. Alright, so for this parenthesis, we are going to construct first A or B. So we can see A or B right here. Okay, the construction is right here. Then with the clean closure has only one child. Okay, so clean closure only one operand, so this is the way the clean closure is performed. Then concatenation are denoted by this circle. So this circle represents the concatenation of the regular expression. So in this way we construct the entire syntax tree. Okay, so the first is A or B constructed. So we number each position here, each leaf root here, 1, 2, then this all represent the A or B. Okay, or parenthesis. So parenthesis is again an operation. This represents the same operation. So we do not represent parenthesis in the syntax tree. Okay, it automatically refer to the expression present within that. So this is we got A or B star, and this got A or B star. Okay, then we got here the cat operation here. So it is A or B star concatenated with A. So each node here, each interior node represent a regular expression, the leaf nodes as well, but leaf nodes represent a symbol of regular expression. So we get a cat node, star node, or node, all are used to construct the syntax tree for the regular expression. Next up is to compute some of the functions which are required to build or to construct the DFA. Alright, so these are called nullable, first pass, last pass, and follow pass. Nullable for every node n is true if and only if the sub expression represented by n has an epsilon or is an empty string in its language. So if any regular expression denoted by the node contain empty string, okay, then we say the nullable will become true. First pass represent the set of positions, okay, in the subtree rooted by at the node n that corresponds to the first symbol of at least one string in the language of the sum expression which is rooted at n. Okay, so the each node for each node, okay, which represent a regular expression, which represent the language of strings, okay, the first must try to find out the all possible positions which contribute at least one string, okay, which will contribute at least one. So taking all positions makes us the first position of the node n. Similarly, the last position, the set of positions in the subtree rooted n that corresponds to the last symbol of at least one string, that is okay, the language of sub expression rooted at n. Okay, now follow us a bit different. So follow us trying to find out a given all possible strings of the regular expression represented by the tree, but by the entire tree. Okay, it tried to find out which position may follow which position in any possible strings. Okay, consider any possible strings represented by the tree, the entire regular expression r hash, more precisely. So using r hash, suppose you build any string, let's say x, with a1, a2, a3, an symbols present in there, then if a2 is contributed by the position p and k3 is contributed by, let's say, position q, then q will be in the follow post of p. That's what the definition says about. Okay, we'll see the procedures, recursive procedure to construct all of them. Okay, so here is the procedure to construct, okay, to construct the all these functions using recursion. Okay, so for a leaf level, a level with e, let's say if you have a leaf with empty string, then null level is true, first post is null, last post is null. Now if a leaf node any with position I, given a position I which is a non-e node, okay, then the null level is false and the first position is the position itself, last position is the position itself, the same, both are same because it is the only symbol, okay, and it is the position is started in the starting position and the end position itself. Now and or node, okay, let's say we have to see that both concatenation and the or nodes. Okay, if it is an or node, let's say, okay, if it is in the form of n equal to c1 or c2, okay, where c1 is the left child and c2 is the right child of the operation of the or operation, then the nullable is the nullable of c1 or nullable of c2. First post is equal to first post of c1 or first post of c2, and last position of post of n is equal to last post of c1 and union last post of c2. Why this is important? Because we know that in or node either can be true, means either left child is will appear or right child is going to appear, none of the side may appear at a time, so both may contribute string. So the first position, both may contribute the first position, any for any string it may constitute the first position, also may contribute the last position. That's why we take the union of both of them. Now for cat node, the null, if both are not nullable, then only we say the node is not nullable. Okay, if one of them is nullable, okay, then we cannot say that it is not nullable. Okay, so nullable here is nullable c1 and nullable of c2. If both are nullable, okay, then only the cat node. Otherwise, if one of the node is not nullable, then definitely we'll have a string, we'll never get empty string. Okay, for calculating first position, we have to make sure that the child 1 is, if child 1 is nullable, then we take the union of both first position of the child 1 and first position of c2. Otherwise, it always begin with the strings always begin with the first position of c1, so it is equal to the first position of c1. Similarly, for last position, if the children 2 is nullable, means it may contain empty string, then it may, the string may begin with the last position from the c1, so it take the union of both. Otherwise, it always, the string which is generated rooted at the node n always end with the last position of its right child, so that is c2. Okay, for a star node, we see it's a only operand, it has only one operand, so it copies the first position and last position from it. And for any star node, nullable is true because it contains an empty string, it contributes an empty string to the language. Okay. Now this is the algorithm for computing follow pose, okay, finding out follow position. And follow position is computed for only two nodes, that is cat node and star node, not for R node, because we know that in R node neither of the node may follow the other path. Okay, only it is possible in star node or cat node that a node may follow, okay, the C1 may follow C2 or C1 may follow C2, okay, or the node can follow itself. Okay, so in R node either one is possible, so never the position L position is never going to follow R position, never going to follow the L position. That's why let us see how the for cat node is calculated. So given N is a cat node, C1 is a left child, C2 is a right child, then for every position I in the last position of C1, okay, for every position J in the first position of C2, the J is added to the follow pos of I. Okay, J is included into the so follow pos of I is follow pos of I union J. Now if it is a star node, then for each position I in the last position of N and for each position J in the first position of N, the follow pos of I is the follow pos of I union J. So because in star node the same node may be repeated n number of times depending on the how much length, how what is the length of the string, so there can be any length from 0 or more. So in this case, so any position, the position I may means the all the position may follow the all the position itself, all the position which are present in the last position, they may follow the first position. Okay, the first position. Okay, so this is how compute. Let's see the example. Okay, so this is the example we're considering about A or B star, A, B, B. So all leaf nodes are number. This is number position number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So as according to the leaf node, okay, a leaf node which is not empty, the position itself is the first post and last post. So we write on all the first posts on the left hand side of the node and write last post on the right hand side. So for one position, one is the first post, one is the last post. For position two, two is the first post, okay, and two itself is the last post. Okay, so for all leaf node, this is true. You can see it. Okay, now to compute about OR node. OR node, we discuss about that union of the first post of left child and right child. So here, the first post of left child is one. First post of right child is 2, so the union is 1, union 2, so 1, 2. Similarly, the right child from the last position, 1, 2. And for star node, we simply copy from its, okay, from its children, okay. We have already seen this, okay, right here. All right. For the star node, we simply the first post of, it is equal to the first post of only child C1 and the last post of only child. Okay, for the node, all right, simply, so in a star node, we copy from the node, so the first post of star node is 1, 2, last post of star node is also 1, 2. Now let us see for the cat node, okay, cat node, while computing first post, we have to verify that whether the left child is containing empty string or not, can be nullable or not. Is it nullable? Because it's a star node, it is nullable. So if it is nullable, the first post of this cat node is the union of the first post of left child and first post of right child. Okay, so first post of left child is 1, 2, and the first post of right child is 3, so the union is 1, 2, 3. Similarly, now last post, is the right child nullable? Okay, if the right child nullable, then we will take the union of the last post of first and 2. But here we see that the right child is not nullable, the child in 2 is not nullable. That's why the last post of this node is nothing but equal to the last post of the children 2, that is 3. So here 3, here the last post is 3. Similarly, come to this node. Okay, this node, is the left child nullable? It's a cat node. No, since the left child is not nullable, the first post of this node is nothing but the first post of its left child, that is 1 2 3. Similarly, is the right child nullable? No. Since the right child is non-nullable, simply it is equal to the last post is equal to the right last post of the right child or the children number 2. Okay, so in this way we construct the entirety, okay, the first post and follow post of the entire tree. Remember, we compute follow post only after computing first post and follow post, because the definition of first follow post depend upon the definition of first post and follow post. Okay, now let us compute follow post, because this is going to be computed for the entire tree. Okay, this is the entire tree. So, and we consider only the nodes, star nodes and cat nodes. Okay, now come to this star node. Okay, this is the only star node present in this tree. Okay, for all positions present in the last post of those node, okay, that is 1, 2. So go back to the definition, see that. So the each position, for each position I in the last position of n, so all each position I is nothing but 1 and 2. Okay, here the position 1, 2, and for each position in the first post, okay, they may follow these positions, okay, according to the star definition. Okay, the clean closure definition, they may follow. So include 1 in the first post of 1 and first as a follow post of 1 and follow post of 2. Include 2 in the follow post of 1 and follow post of 2. That's what. So it's saying that include all the positions right here, what are present here in the follow post of the each position present in the last post. So we include 1 and 2 as the follow post of, okay, 1 and 2, which are the positions present in the last post. Okay, done. Come to the cat node. Okay, as for the cat node, we say that for all positions present in the last post of children number 2, okay, we include all of them as the follow post, okay, in the follow post of each position present in the, so, position in the last post of children number 1. So, sorry, first position. So, all the nodes, so as per the definition, all the nodes which are there in the first position of children number 2, okay, we include them in the follow post of each position that is present in the last position of C1. So, what are the last positions in the last position of C1? 1 and 2. Okay. What are the positions present in the first position of C1 number 1, 2? That is 3. So, include 3 in the follow post of 1 and 2. This is the result. Okay. So, we include 3 as follow in the follow post of 1, include 3 in the follow post of 2. Okay. Let's come to this node. But come to this node, we'll compute that 4, the last, the position in the last post of C2 will be included in the follow post of the first post of C2 will be included in the last post of C1. Okay, so here, so 4 will be included in the 3. Similarly here, the first post of C2, 5, will be included in the last post of C1, that is 4. So 4 in the follow post of 3, 5 in the follow post of 4, and 6 in the follow post of 5. Now 6 is the last node, so for the last node, the follow post is null. Okay, in this way, we construct the follow post of every node, okay, using these two definitions. So we have to only consider the cat nodes and star nodes to compute follow post. Okay, so once we get this information for every node, then we can construct DFA by using the following algorithm. Okay, this is the algorithm we follow to get the final DFA. Okay, so first step, construct a syntax tree, let's say T, from the augmented regular expression, because so if it's R is your original regular expression, so by a parenthesis, concatenate the end marker and then construct the syntax tree. That means it is ensuring that the concatenation of hash with the regular expression R is the last operation to be performed. Remember that, this is most important. Okay, then compute nullable first post, last post and follow post for the tree T, syntax tree T. Then we'll construct the DFA. Construct D state. Okay, so where D state represents a set of states in DFA D. Okay, and dtran is represent the transition function for the DFAT. Okay, and then we will use the procedure below to construct this one. Okay, the states D are set of positions in T. So state D initially is nothing but the set of position T. Okay, so starting state of D is with the first post of N0. Okay, where N0 is the root node of T. Okay, we have to find out the root node of T, find out the first position of N T. So this set of positions will make the first state, okay, or the starting state of the DFAT, all right. And acceptance state are those containing the position of end marker symbol. So we have also given a position for the end marker, like is here for this example, it is 6, So whichever set of state will contain 6 will be the acceptance state for the final DFA. Alright. So let us use the algorithm. Let us see how the algorithm works. Okay. So initialize D state containing only unmarked state first pass of N0, the starting state. Okay, N0, where N0 is a root node. Find out the first pass of the root node, that is the only state, only unmarked state. Okay. Then while there is an unmarked state S in the D state, okay, we'll mark the state S. Now for each input symbol A, okay, we'll find out the union U. Let's say U be the union of follow pass P for all position P in S that correspond to the symbol A. So given a state S, okay, which contains a set of positions, okay, for any input symbol A, for all input symbol A, let's say consider a first input symbol A, we have to find out what are the positions that corresponds to the symbol A. Okay, if at all there is some positions that correspond to the symbol A. Okay, then find out the follow pass of these positions and take the union of it. Okay, if after making this union, U is the new state. Okay, you form the state U. If U is not in D state, means it you form a new state. Okay, you form a new combination of the positions. Okay, that makes a new state in the DS. Then you add U as the unmarked state in the D state. Okay, and you continue this process. Okay. Marking a state and trying to find out all positions. So we will try here. This for loop is going to run for every input symbol on every state. Okay, so we have to define the transition for on every input symbol. So we are going to construct that. Let us see how this algorithm works with the given example. Okay. So the DFA is initialized with the state, the starting state, which is nothing but the first pass of the root node, what we discussed. Okay, what is the first pass of this root node? It is 1, 2, 3. So the 1, 2, 3 makes the starting state of DFA. Okay, now for every position, every input symbol, we have to find the transition. We have to find whether which state it is, whether we are going to construct a new state. So this is the only unmarked state. Now mark this state. Now for input symbol A, how many input symbols we have here? A and B. So let us consider A. What are the position in among 1, 2, 3 correspond to the symbol A? 1, 2, 3. So you can see the position 1 and 3 correspond to the symbol A. Find out the follow pass of these two positions. Okay, what is the follow pass of position number 1? We have already seen that follow pass of this position number 1 is 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, so with the positions 1, 2, 3, we found only 1, 2, and 1, 2, the follow pass of 1 is 1, 2, 3, and the follow pass of 3 is 4. So among all this, we have to consider only follow pass of 1 and 3, which is nothing but 1, 2, 3 and 4. Take the union, that gives 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a new state. So if since you find a new state, add it as an unmarked state. Okay, so we found a transition from 1 to 3 on input symbol a new unmarked state 1 2 3 4. Now consider for B. Okay, so B, so among the positions 1 2 3, which positions correspond to the symbol B? That is the position 2. Okay, so find out the follow pass of position 2, that is 1 2 3. So the only position is 2, so that is 1 2 3. So on transition B, we reach the same set of state 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 is already a marked state. Okay, so we define the transition B on the state 1, 2, 3. Alright. Now we got only unmarked state, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. Now take 1, 2, 3, 4 and try to find out, okay, all transitions. Now for input symbol A, try to find out among the positions 1, 2, 3, 4, which are corresponds to the symbol A. That is, among 1, 2, 3, 4, the position 1 and 3 correspond to the symbol A. So find out the follow pass of them. For 1, follow pass is 1, 2, 3. For 3, follow pass is 4. So union is 1, 2, 3, 4. That means on transition A, okay, the control, the automata remains in the same state, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us define for B. Among the position 1, 2, 3, 4, what are the positions that correspond to B? The position number 2 and position number 4. Okay, find out the union, find out the polar position, take the union. Alright, so polar position 2 is 1, 2, 3. Polar position 4 is 5. So it makes 1, 2, 3, 5. A new state in the DFA. So define a new state on this DFA, mark it as add this as an unmarked state and define the transition, okay, of B from 1, 2, 3, 4 to 1, 2, 3, 5. Alright. Now we'll define the transition for 1, 2, 3, 5. Okay. Now among 1, 2, 3, 5, okay, which are the position correspond to the symbol A, that is 1 and 3 again. So 1 and 3 means on input A, it is going to the state 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that is union of 1, 2, 3. And the 3 has follow plus 4, so we will get 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what are the position correspond to B? The position B is 2 and 5. Okay, so take the follow plus and union, follow plus and 5, the union. For 2, the follow plus is 1, 2, 3. For position 5, the follow plus is 6. So it makes 1, 2, 3, 6. 1, 2, 3, 6 is a new state. Okay, add a new state, define the transition. Okay, and this is the unmarked state, the only unmarked state. So now again consider the transition for this state. Okay, in 1, 2, 3, 6, this state, 1, 2, 3, the position 1, 2, 3, 6, the position 1, 3 corresponds to the symbol A. Okay, so 1, 3. So again, on input symbol A, okay, you take the follow pulse 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it is going to the state 1, 2, 3, and an already existing state. Okay, so no new state we found. Okay, and with 1, 2, 3, 6 on input symbol B, okay, so the position is only 3, okay, the 2 correspond to the symbol B because we have 1, 2, 3, 6, okay, 1, 2, 3, 6, 6 correspond to the end marker, that's why the only position is B. So take the follow pulse of the position number 2, that is 1, 2, 3, so on input symbol B, it goes to 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 is no more new state, it's already existing in the DFA. So define the transition from 1, 2, 3, 6 to 1, 2, 3 on the input symbol B. That's it. So after defining all the transitions, okay, we do not find any new unmarked state. So this while loop is going to stop when there is no unmarked state. So we are done. So this is the final DFA. Job is to define which is the acceptance state. Okay. As we tell that the state containing the position for end marker will be the acceptance state. The position for end marker is number 6. So that's how the 1, 2, 3, 6, the state 1, 2, 3, 6 becomes the acceptance state of the final DFA. Okay. So this is how we construct the final DFA from regular expression by computing nullable first post, last post, and follow post. Thank you all. Hello everyone. In this session, I'm going to discuss about how to construct e-NFA from a regular expression using the induction process, which is also called the structural induction process. Okay, so there was just some doubts among the students regarding how to construct this process. So let me discuss this process again. That how we will construct, given a regular expression, how we are going to construct the e-NFA using the structural induction process. Okay, so regular expression by definition is inductive definition. For we'll see, given all the bases and all the operations, how we're going to construct, how we're going to follow the construction process to get the e-NFA equivalent to equivalent for the regular expression. Okay, so the basis, in the basis we say that in a regular expression that epsilon is also a represented language, null also represented language, also any symbol A that, okay, that belongs to the alphabet set sigma is also a language, a regular language, so they represent regular expression. Now how to construct that an e-NFA for this? Okay, if it is a E, if the regular expression is a E, okay, then we construct two states, a starting state, an acceptance state, and level, the only edge we define from the starting state to the acceptance state, that is where the E move, okay, and that defines the e-NFA for regular expression E. Similarly, for empty language, null is an empty language. Okay? For empty language, we consider two states, starting state and acceptance state, and we don't define no transition in this state to the acceptance state. Okay, so that makes this language empty. This is e-NFA accept an empty language. Okay, now for a regular expression A, okay, which correspond to the symbol A, okay, which also is the only symbol A belongs to sigma. Okay, in this case, we consider two states, one the starting state and acceptance state, and we define a transition on the input symbol A from the starting state to the acceptance state. So this indicates that the e-NFA that accepts the regular expression, okay, that corresponds to the regular expression A. So for any input symbol present in the sigma, we can follow the process shown in the below here. Okay, we can use this one to define the regular expression. The basis regular expression for any symbol that belongs to the sigma or that corresponds to the regular expression A. Now, inductive part, in induction part, we first see the how we can construct, okay, our e-NFA that corresponds to the OR of or the OR operation of two regular expressions. Let's say we have a regular expression T, which is R or S, okay, the union of R or S, okay, so of two regular expressions. So assume that we have already constructed using the inductive construction process the e-NFA for regular expression R, and that is denoted by this box, and we have already constructed the e-NFA for the regular expression S as well. Okay, these two boxes represent that already the e-NFA is constructed. Now, given these two regular expression, the T represent the union of R and S. Okay, so how are we going to construct the regular expression of T using the e-NFA of T using the e-NFAs of R and S? Okay, so for this, we first make the starting states of R and S as non-starting states. Okay, they are no more the starting states. Similarly, make the acceptance states of R and S as non-acceptance state. Okay, non-acceptance state. Then we add two more states, that is one new starting state and a new acceptance state. And we define E moves from the new starting state to the all old starting states of R and S. Similarly, from all old acceptance states of R and S, we define E moves or E transition to the newly constructed starting state. So the final construction or the diagram or e-NFA should look like this. Okay, so given the R and given the S, the R or S is represented in this way, R or S, where R is a regular expression, S is a regular expression. Okay, now this is also very simple for concatenation. So assume that we have two regular expression and the e-NFA is for regular expression. Let's say this represents the e-NFA of R and this represent of S, and we need to construct the e-NFA for regular expression, which is the concatenation of regular expression R and S. Okay, RS, or more precisely RS. So in this case, we'll take them now side by side. Okay, the ENF of R and S side by side. Make the acceptance state of R as non-accepting state, number one. Number two, make the starting state of the S as a non-starting state. Alright, that's it. And we define only one E move or only one E transition from the acceptance state of R, okay, all possible acceptance state of R, to the starting state of S. And this is the resulting e-NFA is representing the regular expression RS, R concatenated with S. Okay. Then comes to construction of the clean closure. Okay, we know that definition of clean closure, it is nothing but if s equal to R star, where R is a regular expression, it says S is containing zero or more occurrence of R. Okay, that indicates the zero or more occurrence of R. Okay, so means it may contain empty string. So S may represent an empty string where its length of equal to zero, maybe one occurrence R or RR, or maybe triple R, 4 Rs, anything like that. So you have to take care of that. So to construct S from R, we assume that we already have R. We already constructed R using again the inductive process. All right. Let's say this box represents the e-NFA of R. Okay. This box represents the e-NFA of R. Then we first step, we make the starting state of R as a non-starting state. Similarly, we make the acceptance state of R as non-accepting state. All right. Then after this, we add two new states similar to the other construction processes, that a starting state and a new acceptance state. All right. Then we define or we add four e transitions. Okay. First e transition is from the old acceptance state to the old starting state. Okay. Second, from new starting state to the old starting state. Okay. Then from old starting state to the new acceptance state. And the last one, from the old acceptance state to the new acceptance state. Okay. I repeat, we add first transition between the old acceptance state to the old starting state. Second, from new starting state to the old starting state. Third, from the old new starting state to the new acceptance state. And the fourth, from the old acceptance state to the new acceptance state. Okay. And so it represents R stars, means zero or more occurrence of R, clean closure of R. So we can easily verify that this part, this E transition, corresponds to the acceptance of the string E or empty string. Okay. So this ENFA accepts empty string. As well, it is going to accept any repetition of R. Okay. So this path of transition represented R from this starting state via this R box. Okay. Now, if you want any repetition, so by this E move, by this E transition, we can accept any occurrence, any number of occurrence of R, and still the string is going to be accepted. Okay, so that's how we construct ENFA of R star, which represents a clean closure of an irregular expression R. Okay, and if S equal to parenthesized R, then the automata of R also serves as the automata of parenthesis R. So S, the automata for the ENFA of R parenthesis, will be same as the ENFA of S. So in this case, no additional construction is required when there is a parenthesis operation. Okay. This is how, using all these steps we discussed for clean closure, for concatenation, for OR, and using the basis construction process, we can construct any ENFA. Okay. Let's see an example. Let us see how we can construct, okay, 0 or 1 star, 0 or 1, 0, 1, 1. Now to break it. Okay, we're going to this way to break it. We're going to start from the basis. All right. So the basis symbols are right here is 0 and 1. Okay. So 0 represent is a regular expression. 1 represent a regular expression. Now let us construct the ENFA for this. Okay. For 0, so starting state, acceptance state, the only transition 0 from starting to acceptance state. For 1, similarly, okay, starting state, acceptance state, the only transition 1 from the start, okay, from the beginning to the acceptance state. Now OR operation. Okay, so now this represents, so this part is represents as our the regular, I can say the ENFA of R, let's say. Okay, and this is represent the ENFA of S. Here for this case, my R equal to 0, S equal to, as R is equal to 0 and S equal to 1. Alright. So I have to go to consider T, which is R or S. Alright. So mark this as these states as non-accepting states. Okay. So I have marked them as a non-accepting. I have numbered them Q1, Q2, and Q3, Q4, which is the non-accepting state, non-starting state, making all of them. Okay. Then adding a new starting state, Q0. New acceptance state QF, alright, and adding 4 new E transitions from new starting state to the old starting states, am from old acceptance state to the new acceptance state. So this represents 0 or 1. Alright, now let us construct the clean enclosure. Okay, so by the process we are going to construct the clean enclosure of 0 or 1. We already had the e-NFA of 0 or 1. Okay, so this one is okay, where the q1 was the starting state and q6 was accepting state. Okay, now let us start with constructing the clean enclosure of 0 or 1. We already discussed the definition that the ENF of 0 plus 1 is same as ENF of parenthesis 0 plus 0 or 1. Alright, so same, we did not have to construct anything new. Alright, so this represents, so this part of ENFA represents the ENFA of 0 or 1, the parenthesis is 0 or 1. Now we're going to construct the clean enclosure. Okay, make the starting state as non-starting state, make the acceptance state as a non-acceptance state, add two new states, one starting state, one acceptance states. Okay, now four new E transition to be defined on this ENFA. Okay, first from the old acceptance state to the new to the old starting state, number one. Number two, from the new starting state to the old starting state, number two. Okay, from q0 to q1, from the new starting state to the new acceptance state, from q0 to qf. Okay, here it is. All right and the last one, from the old acceptance state to the new acceptance state. Okay, last one. So this represents the ENFA for clean enclosure of 0 or 1. Okay, so we're done with this one. We have constructed this sub expression of regular expression. Okay, we constructed this sub expression for the regular expression. Now job is to just construct 0, 1, 1. Okay, that I have done using a shortcut method, means quickly concatenating. So I'm I'm merging the starting state and acceptance state of 0 and 1, and for between this one. So as a whole, this represents the ENFA of 0, 1, 1. Okay, so this line, okay, from Q0 to QF represents 0, 1. Now, finally, this is the final ENFA we'll get by concatenating, okay, by concatenation operation of this sub expression 0 plus 1 star 0, 1 and 0, 1, 1, means this one. Alright. So we have to perform the concatenation on this. So this is the final way. Okay, so this is this part. Okay, this part represents 0 or 1. Okay, 0 or 1 star and 0 or 1. Okay, this part represents 0, 1, 1. So we made the acceptance state of the first part as non-accepting state. We made the starting state of the second part as, means that is Q13, state number 13 as non-starting state, Q12 as a non-accepting state, and we define a E transition, simply a E transition from Q12 to the Q13, to the state number 12 to 13 by on inputs on E. Okay, so the E transition defined, which makes the final ENFA for the expression 0 or 1 star 0 or 1 0 1 1. Okay, so this is how we construct recursively. So it's a recursive process to construct the ENFA from the regular expression. Okay, so here the process is that it's a kind of divide and conquer approach. We divide the regular expression into sub expressions, okay, till we find the basis a regular expression, so that we can construct them directly using the simple inductive process defined in this part, in the basis part. Okay, and then applying the operations on them. Okay, the inductive process or inductive construction process of operation, okay, recursively on them to construct the final ENFA. Okay, thank you very much. This is all about constructing ENFA from regular expression.